Welcome to Books and Company. Bienvenidos todos. I'm your host, Alberto Rios. We're joined today by Jenn McKinlay talking about her latest cozy mystery, Dark Chocolate Demise.
I love that.
It takes a little while. You want to savor that death, right?
Yeah.
You're writing about cupcakes, and
right.
You're writing about bakeries, and you're writing about people mm-hmm. who come and go, and it's just sort of the regular life of things.
Mm-hmm.
In this particular case, it's this small group that you've identified. This is your seventh book in the series.
Yeah.
And so they've come to form a little community.
Oh, definitely.
They know each other, and does that mean you knock somebody off every time? This is a dangerous group to know.
Oh, no, I don't think I'm gonna hang out with them now.
It's kind of funny. As a writer though, it's a privilege to get that opportunity to create a group like that.
It is.
And to stick with them and have a publisher stick with them.
Yes.
You had some trouble breaking in.
Oh,
and maybe you can talk to us about that and what it is for a writer to keep knocking at the door.
Oh, absolutely. For me, I started writing romance because I thought they were easy.
Mm-hmm.
And when it's not your gift, mm-hmm. it's not easy. And subsequently, although I did get published with a few romance novels, I was kindly asked to please stop submitting. So it was a kind of a do or die moment. It was, well, do I write what I've really always wanted to write, which is the mystery, mm-hmm. even though I was lacking confidence? Or, you know, do I try and find what else is told? You know, people say, oh, that's easy, write those, mm-hmm. those are easy. And I thought, you know what, I'm gonna try and write what I like to read, what I love, what's my passion. So I did write several mysteries. Interestingly enough, they were not as traditional and cozy as this one.
Okay.
The first one was set in Old Town, much like the cupcake series,
okay.
but it featured a woman who ran a fish and bird kind of store, but was married to a guy who owned all the strip clubs. They had divorced, and then she finds his body in the fish tank being eaten by the fish.
Oh.
So not terribly cozy, you know.
Not exactly.
No.
Not exactly.
I was fortunate that an agent read that and thought, you know, you have a voice. You have a very strong, strong voice, which after all the books I had written, and I think I had, at that point, I'd written the three romances, I'd probably written two mysteries, and I'd even done a stint trying to write historicals, because when I moved to Arizona mm-hmm. at 25, I just fell in love with it, and I lived in the history section of the library just reading everything. So I had about six or seven novels under my belt. So I knew I could write a whole book.
Actually, let's just stop at that for a moment.
Yeah.
You had a number of novels.
Mm-hmm. I had a
written.
Lot. I did.
So this is the practice element. This is the becoming a writer element.